In today's video, we are going back to the place where I was in last Thursday's video, where I was trying the new OM-1 Mark II on bird photography. This Falconer has a lot of birds, and after the coffee break, I mounted the 150 to 600 lens, so the new OM system super zoom lens. And I tested it on birds, flying birds, even mouses. So yeah, let's get back to that place and let me show you the rest of the afternoon and all the images that I took of these birds with the 150 to 600 ohm system lens on the ohm system OM-1 Mark II camera. So if you're interested in the OM-1 Mark II with the 150 to 400 f4.5 pro lens, then make sure to check out this video up here. You will see all the images that I shot in last week's video, and this video is the same location but the different lens. So let's head into the video and I will show you the results. So right now we're doing something really funny. They got two mouses that they are putting on some leaves, some flowers, and they got an onion ball in the flower. It looks really nice. So they tried to get those mouses up in the flowers. I hope you can see it on the video footage that I'm recording. But yeah, it looks really nice. So these are the shots of the mouse in the flower, and in my opinion, some of them don't really work. So the flower is sharp, but the mouse on top of it is already out of focus. So it's a bit difficult to get the right focus on the mouse. So I hope a couple of them worked. If they did, then these are the shots. So right now we're photographing a bee eater and an owl, a Ural owl, I think. And they just look really, really cool. So it's difficult to get them in flight. These are small birds, but really fast. And yeah, with all those people around, it's quite difficult. So we're just getting those close-ups, and you can really see the feathers with the Yeah, the leaves that they're on. So it's an amazing scene that you can photograph it right here. And they just fly around here and get back to the person that trained them. So the training is probably very good because they always return back to him. So that's really nice. So these are the shots of the bee eater and the Ural owl. And I hope they worked. And these are also with the 150 to 600 on the OM1 Mark II camera. So let's see if these worked out, if they are in focus. And if I look at them on the back of the screen, you can really see the feathers of those birds. So really happy with those shots. Right now they are getting the sea adler, a large bird, and they warned us that they usually only fly over once. So we're going to try to get the bird with this 150 to 600 in flight. So he said he was going to be at the other end of this water, and then he's going to fly over there, sit over there, and he's going to throw a fish in the water, and he's going to get it and get onto the beak right in front of us. So he's going to fly straight towards us. Hope I'm gonna film it. I put a film camera here on the side. Hopefully I can film it in flight, and I'm gonna try to get a picture of it in flight also. So let's see if this is gonna work or not. So the European sea adler. Those are the images. Hopefully they work in flight.
Thank you.
So this bird over here is the Siberian hawk, and it's eating a dove at the moment, but it looks really nice and I can get pretty close to it with this 150 to 600. You can really catch the details in this feather and the eyes of this hawk, but if you're so close like this, the beak of the bird is already out of focus when you're focusing on the eye, so that's quite difficult. But yeah, I can really get some nice close-up shots of this bird. So Siberian hawk shots, yeah, these are the shots, and hopefully these are in focus as they look on the camera, but I think they are. So these are the shots. So this is it for today's video. I hope you liked this quite of different video. Yeah, I'm pretty impressed by the Owen Mark II and those two lenses, the 150 400 and the 150 600. I think on the back of the camera these images look amazing with amazing detail, but in a different video I'm going to look at some close-ups of these images. So if you want to see that, want to see more, then subscribe to the channel, and yeah, I will eventually make a video, maybe next week, the week after, or somewhere soon, I have no idea yet, but I will be back in the office and then yeah, show those images again. So yeah, I enjoyed my time here, very friendly people, beautiful birds, and yeah, hopefully one day I can shoot those in the wild somewhere, but this was good practice and a good time to test this camera and these lenses. So hope you enjoyed it. Hope to see you on the next video. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, don't forget, please push the thumbs up button and leave a comment underneath here. And I always like to engage with everybody watching this channel. So yeah, once again, if you didn't already, please push the subscribe button, and I hope to see you on the next video, which will probably be on location in Sweden again, because I'm not through that series yet. So thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye bye.